Good day, my lord.
Good day, Barker.
Will anyone be joining your lordship?
No, I shall be alone. Thank you.
The roast beef's very good, my lord.
Hello, Neville. How are you?
Ah, Barry. Hello.
I see you're alone. Why don't you come over and join me?
Well, thank you, Barry. You're very kind, but I'm expecting someone to join me soon.
Ah, what a shame. Lady Lyndon and I have missed your company lately.
Well, please give my respects to Lady Lyndon and say I've been very busy of late and not been able to go about much.
I shall. By the way, on the 8th of next month, we're having some guests over for cards. We'd love to have you and Lady Wendover join us.
Check my diary, but I think I'm engaged on that evening.
Well, I hope you're not engaged. We'd love to see you again.
If I may, I'll write and say if I'm free or not.
I look forward to hearing from you. It's nice to see you again, Neville.
If he had murdered Lord Bullingdon, Barry could scarcely have been received with more coldness and resentment than now followed him in town and country. His friends fell away from him, and a legend arose of his cruelty to his stepson. Now all the bills came down on him together. All the bills he had been contracting for the years of his marriage and which the creditors sent in with a hasty unanimity. Their amount was frightful. Barry was now bound up in an inextricable toil of bills and debts, of mortgages and insurances, and in all the evils attendant upon them. And Lady Lyndon's income was hampered almost irretrievably to satisfy these claims.